In this video, we will discuss about the working process of stereolithography apparatus, principles, applications, and finally advantages and disadvantages of stereolithography process. Let's start with the process of SLA. The stereolithography process begins with the vat, filled with the photo-curable liquid resin, and the elevator table is set just below the surface of the liquid resin. Then the operator loads a 3D CAD solid model file into the system. For the parts to build, we need supports, so supports are designed to stabilize the part during building. After obtaining the required digital files, the software translator converts the CAD data into a STL file. The control unit slices the model and support structure into a series of cross sections from 25 microns to 0.5 mm thick. Then, after slicing into thin 2D cross sections, the computer-controlled optical scanning system directs and focuses the laser beam on these cross sections so that it solidifies. The elevator table then drops just enough to cover the solid polymer with another layer of the liquid resin. A leveling wiper or vacuum blade moves across the surfaces to recoat the next layer of resin on the surface. The laser then draws the next layer on the adjacent printed layer. This process continues building the part from bottom up until the system completes the entire part. The part is then raised out of the vat and cleaned of excess polymer. The next step is post-processing operation. This final step needs some level of skill for the operator, or the chances of damaging the printed 3D part is high. Post-processing includes carefully removing the part from system platform, cutting off the support structures, and finishing to get the final part. Principles of stereolithography process. The SLA process is based fundamentally on the following two principles. They are: 1. Parts are built from a photo-curable liquid resin that cures when exposed to a laser beam, which scans across the surface of the resin. 2. The building is done layer by layer, each layer being scanned by the optical scanning system and controlled by an elevation mechanism which lowers at the completion of each layer. Applications. The SLA technology provides manufacturers with cost-justifiable methods for reducing time to market, lowering product development costs, gaining greater control of their design process, and improving product design. The range of applications include: 1. Models for conceptualization, packaging and presentation. 2. Prototypes for design, analysis, verification, and functional testing. 3. Parts for prototype tooling and low-volume production tooling. 4. Patterns for investment casting, sand casting, and molding. 5. Tools for fixture and tooling design and production tooling. Advantages of SLA. The main advantages of using SLA are: 1. Round-the-clock operation. The SLA can be used continuously and unattended round-the-clock. 2. Good user support. The computerized process serves as a good user support. 3. Build volumes. The different SLA machines have build volumes ranging from small to large to suit the needs of different users. 4. Good accuracy. The SLA has good accuracy and can thus be used for many application areas. 5. Surface finish. The SLA can obtain one of the best surface finishes amongst 3D printing technologies. 6. Wide range of materials. There is a wide range of materials, from general purpose materials, to specialty materials for specific applications. Disadvantages of SLA. The main disadvantages of using SLA are: 1. Requires support structures. Structures that have overhangs and undercuts must have supports that are designed and fabricated together with the main structure. 2. Requires post-processing. Post-processing includes removal of supports and other unwanted materials, which is tedious, time-consuming, and can damage the model. 3. Requires post-curing. Post-curing may be needed to cure the object completely and ensure the integrity of the structure. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more engineering concepts and happy learning.